Prince Harry has revealed how he thinks his mother, Diana, would feel about his feud with Prince William just 4 days out from his bombshell book officially being released. Time now for our US correspondent, Alison Petrowski, in Los Angeles. Ali, what did Harry say?
Well, Gavin, he said that he thinks his mother would be really sad about the rift that has developed between he and his brother William. Harry has made these comments while sitting down with Michael Strawn from Good Morning America. Let's listen to some of it.
I think she'd be looking at it long term to know that there are certain things that we need to go through to be able to heal the relationship. I have felt the presence of my mum more so in the last 2 years than I have in the last 30.
Now in Spare, Harry talks about going to a psychic in the hopes that she might be able to connect him to his late mother. He talks about driving through the Paris tunnel where she died in 1997 in the hopes that that journey might bring him some closure. And he also talks about taking William on that same journey through the tunnel and that both of them had a number of questions about the official account of her death. So, Gavin, it becomes very clear in Spare that Harry has been haunted and plagued by Diana's death throughout his life.
Yes, I think the effects of that are still affecting him today. Now, Ali, the Taliban has also made comments about the prince.
Yeah, that's right. So Harry in Spare has said that he killed 25 Taliban fighters, but it's not necessarily the number that struck a chord, but really the way he spoke about it. He refers to Taliban insurgents as chess pieces that needed to be taken off the board. Now, some British military figures say this has not only tarnished Harry's reputation, but also painted the British army in a pretty negative light. The Taliban too has hit back, as you mentioned, a senior official saying, "The ones you killed were not chess pieces. They were humans. They had families who were waiting for their return." And Gavin, as for the royal family, a stony silence, and we expect it to stay that way.
Yes, at times he's saying all the wrong things. Thank you so much, Ali.
Headlines for the royal family this morning. The Taliban accusing Prince Harry of committing war crimes after he revealed that he killed 25 enemy fighters while he was serving in Afghanistan. Harry described them as chess pieces removed from the board in his new memoir, Spare.
So for more, we're joined by Royal Editor at the Daily Mirror, Russell Myers. Good morning, Russell. Military figures have come out and criticised his decision. Do you think he expected to face such a backlash on this revelation?
Well, good morning. I'm certain he probably didn't, but like many things in this explosive memoir, I'm sure Harry hasn't thought a lot of the things through. I mean, he's not only sort of savaged his own family, but the real other family that he had was the British military. And by saying these incredible comments that he slaughtered 25 insurgents while in Afghanistan, he has not only put his own comrades at danger, but he's put his own family at danger as well. And I think you see the statement coming out by Lord Darrick, who's a former national security advisor to the British Armed Forces, Tim Collins, retired colonel in the British Army. I mean, they have all widely condemned his words, and I think that is pretty powerful.
This isn't something that he accidentally let slip. I mean, this is written in black and white in a book, presumably something that's been looked over by numerous pairs of eyes. And now, suddenly, it seems that security concerns have come out. Why didn't they think that through?
Well, it's even worse than that, because in 2013, when this actually happened and he had left the British Army, he actually revealed that he had killed insurgents, and he was widely admonished at the time. He was ticked off by the army brass. He had been told, you know, to keep his mouth shut, basically. And now to even go further and to be more specific, talking about numbers while he's out of the British Army and you know, still a senior member figure of the royal family, regardless of whether he's left or not. I mean, it's just absolutely extraordinary that he would be so cavalier. But it's almost beggars belief that he's put it in the book alongside all these other pretty damaging claims.
After declaring that they wanted privacy, Harry has another interview, this time Good Morning America on Monday in the US, to discuss his rift with his brother and what his mum, Princess Diana, would think. He's certainly broken the code of silence that the family seems to do so well.
Well, he's going all over the place breaking codes, isn't he? He's been breaking the code of the British Army. He's breaking family code as well. I mean, speaking to people that have known both the brothers for many, many years, right up from their childhood, they're absolutely dumbfounded. And I think the sense that comes out of all of this book and the situation is one of complete sadness. And people who knew Diana would say she would be absolutely crestfallen if she knew what had happened to her two boys, who she really did see as equals growing up. And for Harry to have that sort of entwined within his psyche, that he was so at loss to explain his place in the world, I think is terribly, terribly sad.
Mm. I mean, there were enough interviews that the couple had done before this book that I think a lot of us were thinking, well, what else could he possibly reveal? But then it seems going. Like there's a lot in there, including the relationship between Prince William and Meghan. What do you make of all this, all these bombs that he's dropping?
Well, how many times have we, you know, all sat here and said, what on earth can they say next? And there's the Oprah Winfrey interview, then, you know, he pops up on US television, then the Netflix series. I mean, it's utterly extraordinary. And we're seeing dozens and dozens of, you know, bombshells in this memoir. But you know, the detail that he goes into about Meghan and William's relationship is really quite hurtful. He talks about Meghan having to tell William off for him waving his finger in her face, the fact that she didn't get on with Kate as well. Kate would sort of grimace when she was near her. I mean, it's really, really detailed stuff. And regardless of what you think of the two couples, just to reveal intimate details of private conversations of that is actually really, really awful, I think the family will think.
Just makes me sad. I just want those brothers to be friends. I think we all do, don't we?
They better invest their money wisely. It may not last forever.
All right, Russell Myers from the Daily Mirror, thank you.
Welcome back to Weekend Today. Prince Harry has been accused of committing war crimes by a senior Taliban leader after admitting he killed 25 enemy fighters in Afghanistan. It's seen a retired commanding officer accuse the royal of turning against his military family and raised serious security concerns. Let's bring in today's talkers, Victorian Senator Jane Hume and Triple M's Gus Wallen. Good morning to you both.
Morning.
Jane,
morning.
To you first of all. In the book, Harry says, "It wasn't a statistic that filled me with pride, nor did it make me ashamed." This is not going down well.
No, I think that there are an awful lot of people in the British military and indeed military around the world, particularly those that participated in the Afghani conflict, that would be very disappointed in this, particularly the reference to his victims being, you know, seen as sort of subhuman. That really is inappropriate. Look, in my mind, this book, the sooner it ends up in the remainder bin at Dimmicks, the better. I really don't think Harry has covered himself in glory on so many levels, and this is just the next misstep that he's made. I don't know who is advising him, but his PR is terrible, as well as his judgment.
Yes, absolutely. A really surprise admission there. Gus, what are your thoughts?
Yeah, I agree with Jane. Whoever's sort of advising him at the moment, it's getting it completely wrong, you know, talking the way that he has spoken about the people that he killed. And the simple fact is, I'm not a military man. I respect everything that our military does. But if they're saying to us that this is inappropriate, then who are we to turn around and say that they're wrong? So I'm with them 100%. And I've been disappointed in Harry for quite a while now. Why would you want to be doing all the stuff that he's doing, the Netflix thing as well as the book? To me, it just comes across as someone who is being really poorly advised.
Absolutely. I've read some books on the SAS and they pride themselves on humility and treating the enemy with respect. So, real surprise there, and he may ostracise himself, I think, from that community.
Welcome back. In a new interview set to air Monday on Good Morning America in the United States, Prince Harry is opening up about his relationship with his older brother, Prince William, and their highly publicised rift. Co-anchor Michael Strahan asking him the tough questions. Take a look.
How would your mom feel about your relationship with your brother now?
I think she would be sad. I think she'd be looking at it long term to know that there are certain things that we need to go through to be able to heal the relationship.
Royal editor at ITV News, Chris Shipp, joins us now. Chris, first of all, good morning. Do you agree with Harry's response, first of all, regarding Princess Diana?
Yeah, look, I mean, Harry and William very rarely speak about Princess Diana, so when they do, we have to listen. And clearly, this was a significant moment in both of their lives. And does any parent want their children to be fighting in the way in which Harry and William are? And does any parent want that to sort of break out into the public domain? The answer to that is no. And particularly now, Harry's, as we've discovered this week, had this fight with William in the kitchen of his house and broke a dog bowl in the process and all the rest of it. It's messy, it's uncomfortable reading at times, and I think Diana, yes indeed, would have been very sad.
Do we think the royal family or the palace is going to respond to those allegations about the fight? And do you think there is any way the brothers can mend this?
Good question. Guess what I do every morning is I reach out to both Buckingham Palace and Kensington Palace and say, hey, do you know all these new lines that we've had either from the book or from this interview or that interview? Any response at all? And so far, nothing. But actually, when we had 6 hours of Netflix at the end of last year, there was nothing from either palace either. So I think the King and William and Kate are going to go back to work next week and try and show through deeds what they do, which is we're going to help support charities and the third sector and all the rest of it. But we're not going to talk about the things that Harry has been talking about in the past week.
Now, the big news, there are security concerns for Harry and the royal family after he opened up about killing 25 Taliban fighters during his second tour of Afghanistan in his second memoir, or the new memoir, Spare. This is worrying, isn't it?
Well, I think perhaps worrying for Harry, because it would perhaps some people, you know, military veterans here in the UK have said make him a greater security risk. But also, there's been a lot of comment here in the UK from the military community about why he did this. Soldiers don't normally talk about how many combatants they've killed. Harry's put this number. He said, you know, so my total is 25. And normally, yeah, of course, soldiers. I mean, what do we think they do when they get sent out by governments to go to Afghanistan? And there are a lot of British soldiers who went there, as there were for a time, Australian soldiers as well. But to talk about it seems to have gone down very badly. And then we had a response today from the Taliban accusing Harry of committing war crimes by killing people in Afghanistan. So, I mean, quite how that made its way into the book, this wasn't from an interview that Harry gave, like an off-the-cuff comment to a question. It was in the book. He'd actually chose to put it in there. The ghostwriter copied it in. The publisher approved it. It must have gone through lots of different stages, and yet it still ended up in the book, this line about killing 25 members of the Taliban. And a lot of the veteran community here in the UK and elsewhere, I think that was a mistake.
Chris, thank you so much for your time. An unwise decision, I think.